It's an all-South Pacific final to decide the gold medal in the men's rugby sevens at Tokyo 2020. It's Fiji, the gold medalists at Rio 5 years ago, against New Zealand. Two of the most exciting, iconic teams in the rugby game, and they'll clash in the final. For many of the, I guess, neutrals, this would be the dream final. Here's the referee, Damon Murphy of Australia, Jordan Way of Australia, Richard Horton of Great Britain. We'll be on the touch lines, and the teams are ready. New Zealand going in with both of their co-captains, Curry and Mickelson. Jerry Tuai, of course, to lead the team out. And he knows that his nation, that beautiful, proud nation, Fiji, everyone is on the edge of their seats. Can they defend the gold medal they won in such brilliant style in Rio, or can New Zealand deny them? New Zealand really have already made amends for the disappointment of Rio when they were knocked out of the medal contention. They're going to get at least a silver, but someone's going to get a gold.
Well, the roller coaster Rugby Sevens gives some just incredible rides, dips, and so many moments of dizzy spells. But if day one's about your psychology, then day three is about a combination of that preparation and application. Not one sinew of your body at this stage of the tournament is thinking this is a good idea, but your mind is set. Your team will carry you, an individual just try and find their way to contribute.
And now the teams, because it's a final, they line up for the national anthems.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthems of New Zealand and Fiji.
New Zealand の国歌の演奏に続いて、フィジーの国歌の演奏です。
Well, impossible not to be moved by the emotion on the faces of the players, particularly the Fiji players who play with such pride in their nation. New Zealand, of course, many of the players not been at an Olympic Games before. Nearly all of the Fijian players haven't been here before. They'll both be hoping to hear that anthem again in an hour or so's time.
We'll have to clear the eyes before we watch the screens and the footage out here. That is a sensational way to start any type of sporting occasion. But make no bones about it, those emotions on show, those tears rolling down the faces are going to be well and truly parked for the next 20 minutes. This game is going to be of the highest degree of physicality.
Here's the patu carved by Andrew Newstub, who's been one of New Zealand's most influential players. And you can see Curry and Mickelson, they've often not been in the team at the same time. But Clark Laidlaw this time, he's throwing in his top seven. Here's the New Zealand coach. Try to stay calm and relaxed. His team turned in a meticulous semi-final effort. Fiji, well, Jerry Tuwai captains a team of extraordinary talent. But also, they've been a great defensive side as well, so hard to break down. It's going to be a battle of wills, a battle of skills, a battle of desire. Which coach has got the winning game plan? A gold medal at stake as Pacific neighbours New Zealand and Fiji start the final of Tokyo 2020. Fiji getting up after it, and they get ball back from the restart. So what a great opportunity for them to spread the ball wide. So much powerful talent. Well, a little kick through from Mangala. Referee looking at the challenge on him, but deciding there was no late hit. He lay prone on the ground for a while after he got the kick away, but referee said the player didn't change his line. So New Zealand will get a line out throw. They're inside their own 22.
Well, different tactic already seen by Fiji. Not often do they kick it in deep. Clearly they think the physical threat of New Zealand will match their imposing style of play. They don't want to be having the breakdowns, and it's one clever way of playing into the backfield.
Oh, Curry wins the line out. The New Zealand captain's been, or co-captain, has been in outstanding form. Joe Weber, they're trying to rip the ball off him, and doing so is Mangala. And so Fiji get an opportunity to score right from the off. Weber getting across to make the tackle, but they're in at the corner. They've got the first try, and it's Mili Derinilangi.
Oh, that is composure. It's often slightly feared when it... You see players crying in the anthems about what's going to happen next, but that's absolute ruthless execution. Targeting the ball, the two-handed rip. Weber's got no chance of keeping hold. Derinilangi starts the movement off, trails on the inside, and that offload off the floor. So typical of how Fiji play the game. They don't want to contest it, want to keep the ball alive, and you're not going to stop Big Mele from there.
Well, he's got such a great skill set. He has been central to their outstanding run through this tournament. Now the kick from out on the sideline. Can they cap a good start? No, they can't. But Fiji, the all-important first try, goes to Big Mele Derinilangi.
Quite rare in this restart. They're loading up this one side. No dual kicking threat. This is out and out looking for Vakua Nabili and Derinilangi.
Well, this time they go down the middle, and once again they get hands to it. The little chip kick through from Bolatha. The chase is on, going back for New Zealand. Newstub gets there first. Or does he? Oh, the referee wants a look at this. Did he force it? Mangala's come through and got a hand to it.
Just want to check to confirm he's been grounding. Yeah. Whether Black's grounded it.
Yeah.
Or White.
Yes.
Well, there's what he's checking, the grounding. James McPhail making the call on it.
Try yes or no, please.
Try yes or no is the question. I'd like to have seen it before, because it looked like the kicker was indeed taken out. Newstub comes back. The ball looks like he's gone through his grasp initially. That is not grounded. The ball is still live. His eyes are closed. He doesn't know where it's going. Does he regather? I don't think he does. That's still a loose ball. And then it's about what happens next. Some serious heat coming in for the Fijians.
Well, has he got any pressure on the ball? Has he pressed down on the ball or not? If not, this is a second try to Fiji.
Was Mangala chasing it, was it?
Mangala has been extraordinary. He's been doing everything.
Damon, I have a decision.
Yeah, mate.
8 Black has not grounded the ball.
Okay.
Therefore, a try to Fiji.
All right, too easy. Thanks, mate.
It's a try, confirmed. Sirelli Mangala, the rookie, a rising star, a new star of Fiji rugby. He puts them in front by 10-0, and they have rocked New Zealand in the gold medal match. The kick goes over, it's 12-0.
Oh, Gareth Barber clearly thinking about tactics, playing in behind. The second kick now from Fiji, find the space in behind. In sevens, you could opt to detach a player known as a sweeper in the backfield. New Zealand not choosing to do that. They are seven flat, as you can see from this restart. This kick now, huge. They've moved Meledewalangi once again. He's the threat. There's players out wide on the right, and they've gone deep.
Oh, Bolata putting the ball deep and asking New Zealand to run it out from deep in their own territory. Well, how can New Zealand respond to this early onslaught? Newstub, who couldn't force the ball in the in goal, takes play up to halfway. New Zealand spreading it wide. Mickelson, Mulia now, Collier. At familiar step back in field. They've taken play almost to the 22. Weber at first receiver. Halfway through the first half, and now here's an opportunity for Curry to put the hammer down. The New Zealand captain is in at the corner. The Kiwis strike back. Scott Curry, the co-captain, scores. It's 12-5.
Scott Curry at the top of the screen. He follows this all the way around, gets the ball, spots a chance. This is a guy who's an out-and-out forward in the game. He is the personification of a perfect sevens player. Big, fast, agile. He's fit as you would like on a sevens pitch. This guy is a supreme athlete. Absolutely right we see him here at the Olympics, because he could probably compete in about 10 different sports.
A new stab, the kick. Well, it started off on target, just drifts away to the right. It's 12-5, but important for New Zealand. With still 2.5 minutes to play in the first half. Important that they found some sort of an answer to that brilliant Fiji start.
And it came from the restart, Fiji choosing for the first time in a long time to kick deep. New Zealand much more astute. They'll have plans, they'll have strategies, and they'll try and get this ball back lightly, going deeper themselves.
Kick it down to the 22. And Mangala is there, brushes off the first tackle, steps, accelerates. New Zealand, well, had hands on the ball, but Mickelson been penalised, and so Fiji look to keep things moving. Big men stationed wide, and here's one of the biggest. Waningolo puts the sprint down, and he's away, and he's in. Waningolo the try. Well, just like that, they restore their advantage. Jutta Waningolo the try.
Waningolo not just quick, as you're going to see here, the ball shifts across to him. He must have the core of steel. Bounces on the outside, gets round the initial efforts of Collier, but then check this. That is a hit that would get most normal humans down. Newstub flying in, but he rode it effortlessly.
Well, just as soon as it looked like New Zealand were getting themselves back into the contest, Fiji strike again. It's amazing, we've had only 6 minutes of action and already the score is 19-5.
Can't afford to go deep again now, Fiji. Need to compete for this ball.
Oh, Curry does brilliantly. He has played some amazing rugby in this tournament, the New Zealand co-skipper. He's got Mickelson there with him.
Straight to the ruck.
And they get a free kick, or a penalty, I should say.
Entry.
Likely going to kick for the corner, get a little bit of territory down in the 22, albeit in sevens. Not as important in 15s about where you get down the line. It's about making sure it's out, because this is the set piece to then start from. You try and secure it with the three forwards who are normally backs in 15, so they have to be well adept at jumping and working together in unison. Scurry lightly, the target up top, and then Weber, the curator at fly half. He needs the ball early.
A new stub will throw. Curry. Well, he's been so good at line-out time. What can they do? Mulia up quickly, but too quickly. Up offside, Weber sprints forward. Wants to take the tap. Just a little frustrated there, but the referee hadn't really picked out the mark for him to take the quick tap. So New Zealand, instead of taking it quickly, will work a move.
There's so many variants of this style. Mickelson often taps it and finds himself bouncing back out to the left. These are the moves that are practiced hundreds of times on the training field. Expect to see Mickelson appear once again in this move.
Weber, little show of the ball, and they peel away to the left. Mickelson is there. Nothing really on. We've gone past the hooter for half time. So New Zealand will want to make the best of this opportunity. And some time added on. This time they're able to take it quickly through Newstub. Mickelson waiting for it, then looking for a little wraparound play. Weber goes up the middle and throws a very loose ball. Oh, lucky for New Zealand that they were able to pick it up, and Mollier showing great determination, breaking clear and scoring.
Oh, he gives a big wave. And that is a huge moment before that whistle went well into the depths of extra time in this first half. All high tackles, you can't afford to do that. Look at his leg drive. That's about carrying beyond the contract, making him power through it. Defenders flying off, and there's the wave home. I'm sure they're proud of you.
Well, that's the sort of determination that you see when there's a gold medal on the line. New Zealand closed the gap up again. At halftime, it's Fiji who leads in the final, 19-12. Well, yet again, wonderful insight, perhaps the odd choice language, which we apologise for, but really clear systems there. Gareth Baber talking admirably to the troops, very much him leading it, as to the senior players of New Zealand talking. Clark Laidlaw just finishing in a summary, but really simple. Play to the referee's laws and interpretation, absolutely. Fiji gave away four penalties in that first half, and each time they do that, they're giving New Zealand a chance to get back in this game consistently. New Zealand really composed. They're just about trying to play with a little bit more width, keeping that ball moving. Do not let Fiji get the ball. Well, Fiji led throughout the first half. They scored first, but New Zealand have hung in there. 7 minutes away from a gold medal for one of these teams. Will it be Fiji to go back-to-back? Or can New Zealand win an Olympic gold medal in a rugby event for the first time? It'll be New Zealand to start the second half. Andrew Newstuff has the ball. Puts it high, and it just goes the 10, and it's a great kick because Dylan Collier has got up after it. Regan Ware didn't take the pass cleanly. And Fiji trying to press up on Andrew Newstub. And he shows great determination to get the ball down to halfway. Mickelson clears. Ware at first receiver. Weber now floating a long ball away to Collier. He'll come back in field and set it. They'll try and hold him up, but it's there for Weber. Ware again, Mickelson, Curry now. He's the man who's made things happen for New Zealand. This time taking the direct route and powering his way downfield, taking a lot of stopping. Mickelson pops the ball away. Waiting for it was Newstub. Weber again. They're going side to side. Mulia now looking to step. The try scorer just before half time. To the ground he goes. Collier. Well, New Zealand have shown the ability in this Olympic tournament to hang on to the ball for long periods of time. Now Regan Weir starts to move forward. Picks the ball up again. Takes another metre and a penalty at the breakdown. Just what Gareth Baber didn't want.
Fiji giving too much respect to the breakdown. They're not trying to contest enough. At the moment, they're going wide, wide, New Zealand, and there's not enough big hits coming through. When Fiji were amazing in their semi-final, it was a consistent pressure, seeking the big hit. Vakunabili, the man who got penalised, but it's not enough coming through. And every tackle the Fijians seem to be making is a grab tackle. There's no leg tackles. There's no one getting thrown to the floor. It's such a small part of the game, but now they're about to bring on the hit man, and that's very much going to change. Number five for Fiji, Tui Vaka. He's just going to go out and whack people.
Oh, looks like Naruhi Mugabe Black coming on for New Zealand too. No players at the opposite end of the weight scale. Tui Vaka, who's put in perhaps the most shuddering hits of this whole tournament. But it's New Zealand who are going to get the throw to the line out. They're behind by seven. 5 minutes to play in the Olympic final. New stuff. Oh, they get up and contest it though, Fiji. And they're going to get a breakout here. And here is the new man. Offload doesn't find the mark, but it doesn't go forward either. Tui Mamba. They've got such power off the bench. Now Tuai dancing around, trying to find an opening. Support there from Bolatha. Now they go away to the right again. Butitu is there, flings the ball away. This is Fiji at their best, offloading the ball and looking for the opportunity. Here he is, Tui Vaka, thundering runner, goes to ground, lays the ball behind. New Zealand trying to counter-ruck. Now they'll have to peel away. Fiji, Bolatha. Well, there's a lot of space away to the left. Tries a little kick through. And in the end, well, grabs it. And it's a penalty against New Zealand.
Well, Fiji in an Olympic final, making rugby sevens like they're playing in the park. They look so composed, ball in hand. They're just that one moment away.
Again, the tactic is the kick through. And the referee, he's not buying a little contact after the kick.
That's a poor option from Tumamba. There is space in behind, but it's not a deceitful enough kick. Collier just has to stand his ground. He doesn't have to move.
Time off, 12, Fiji. Straight in the back of him. Boys, scrum.
Yeah, he's absolutely right. He just ran into the back of him. There was space out there. You just need a little bit of deception, a little chip kick rather than the longer one. And failing that, continue what they've been doing. Because when they are broken, there's no stopping them. They are, to a man, faster than New Zealand.
Tim Mickelson is leaving the field.
Here's your mark.
Mugabe Black's out there.
Time's off still.
There's a bit of confusion up front. Melly Derenalangi heading to the sideline. Nasoka been brought on. That is a pretty impressive substitution, and still with Semi Randrandera potentially going to make an impact in this game.
Well, we're halfway through the second half now. Fiji remain in front by the halftime score of 19-12. Edging towards that back-to-back gold. New stub, though, comes away with it. Mulia. Now, New Zealand have an opportunity through Mugabe Black. It's a beautiful ball away to Regan Weir. He'll step back and field. Oh, he's lost it. Well, New Zealand had an opportunity there, and now Fiji are going to get one down the other end. Nanguthu. Ball taken into contact again. New Zealand looking to try and contest the ball, but Fiji clear it away. You've got a feeling that this is the key phase of the whole game. Who wins the game comes down to who scores next.
So much space in behind as well now.
Tui Mamba straightening and going right over the top of Andrew Newstub, just ankle tap from behind. Manages to offload it. Butitu trying to step inside. Nashu's got him. Fiji trying to put it out of reach. They're just metres from the line. New Zealand desperately trying to counter ruck.
Advantage.
Referee's playing advantage against New Zealand. Here's Tuwai. What can he do? He floats it wide and the big man's going in. And maybe that's a gold medal winning try.
Well, still plenty of time on the clock for this one. Amazing to see such a soft touch from such a hard-hitting human. Tui Mamba. That is some collision we're used to. What an ankle tap. It looks like Fiji are almost making hard work of it when they're in that depths of New Zealand territory. But it's how good this defence is. Relentless. Newstub gets back up, gets himself back downfield. Tui just taking his time to execute this pass. Yes, it could be pivotal, but still I feel New Zealand are threatening in this game. The man who's made so many impacts largely on Argentinian ribs has just made one significantly in this final of the Olympic Games.
Aseli Tuivuaka scores the try. The kick goes wide, but it's a 12-point lead, a minute and a half to play. New Zealand now will have to score twice. Fiji continue to edge towards their golden dream. This time, not bothering with a contestable kick, saying to New Zealand, you want to score? You're going to have to go the length of the field. Tony Nashu, well, he's a player who could spark something, but oh, loss of communication or miscommunication there, and the ball goes into touch.
Well, I'm sure if Scott Curry had any energy left in his body, he might well be wincing at that point. He knows you have to keep the ball against Fiji. Any type of unforced error, it's like hitting a tennis shot in the net, just not able to bounce back from that. Now, Fiji with the ball, they need to do nothing spectacular, but this is Fiji, so I assume they're going to keep trying.
Tuwai into the line, out it goes. Tuwai fetches it. New Zealand now desperately trying to stay in this, but they keep conceding penalties. That one for offside.
30 seconds you get to take this penalty. They can walk to the mark, they can tap it, and with this point differential, game, set and match for Fiji.
Yeah, that penalty, that was the last chance for New Zealand disappearing out there. It was a forlorn hope anyway. And it looks like they're going to have a shot at goal, Fiji. It'll use up the remaining time. It's unusual to see this. But there's a gold medal on the line. The kick glances off the upright. It's over. And there's a golden glow hanging over a beautiful nation. Back-to-back Olympic glory for Fiji.
It's so much bigger than rugby. Such a special moment. Just 800,000 people occupying the islands of Fiji. They've got rugby in their blood. And once again, they've got gold in their eyes. It is such a wonderful sight to see this team play sport. And we're lucky enough that it's in rugby sevens. Commendable from New Zealand. Look at that emotion from the players. New Zealand could not have tried any harder, but sometimes you cannot compete with what Fiji bring to a game.
Well, such devout people, such proud people, they know what it means to their nation, because it's a tough time right now in Fiji, and this, well, they're one of the most happy, smiling people in the world, the Fijians, and they've got so much to smile and be proud about now. What a great performance again from this team. They've had to work hard in pretty much every match.
That man too, I grew up with nothing. And he's now got two Olympic gold medals.
Disappointment for New Zealand. All over their faces, of course, for every winner, there has to be a loser. They'll get a silver medal, New Zealand. That surely will atone for the disappointment of Rio. They would have loved a gold, wasn't to be. Well, unbelievable emotion. We saw it before the game, and now we're seeing it times 10 at the end. 4-2. No question about it. A thoroughly deserved win for Fiji. They controlled the game throughout. New Zealand kept themselves in the hunt. They played well enough to still give themselves a shot at gold, but in the end, Fiji just struck the big blows when they needed them most, at the beginning, at the end, and they come away with another gold medal.
There's a point where New Zealand were 12-19 down. You thought there's still a hope, still a chance, but then the Fiji machine came out strong.
Fiji, the one country in the world where 7's really is king. And you see there, Semi Rundrandra, a man who came into the squad expected to play such a huge role, really in the way a cameo role here and there, but you can see his presence means so much.
Oh, absolutely. He is the highest paid rugby player on the planet, and he could not even get on in that final. That's how good this Fijian team is. A nation with nothing. They don't aspire for the financial gains that many others do, but look at that pure emotion on the face. It's a reflective moment, it's a magical moment, and it's a pleasure to be able to witness it.
Thank you, Coach, for everything. I know you sometimes, you guys step on the wrong foot, you nearly go home, you nearly abandon the camp. And, but somehow, we stick together, and you came. And we know that that's God. Only God can do that. Only God can accomplish everything that is impossible to me. Only God can do it. You can tell him, I'm going to take care of him. But we can't last it, we're going to do it. I'm going to go to the next one. I'm going to go to the next one. I'm going to go to the next one.
Well, they really are the magnificent Sevens players. They play the game the way it's meant to be played, the way it's played the best. Such a popular team. And now they sing.
We have all.
Oh, beautifully led by Napoleone Bolatha. Well, you do get the feeling with some of these players, those tears are going to keep rolling down the face for a time to come. Such devout people, such humble people, but such brilliant athletes. And now they'll come over to receive their gold medals.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du rugby à 7 hommes.
So it's time.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory
for the victory ceremony for the men's rugby sevens at Tokyo 2020. The gold, the silver, and the bronze medals to be presented to Argentina, New Zealand, and Fiji.
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
The two gentlemen you see in the foreground, Dr. Robin Mitchell, who's the Fiji Executive Board member, World Rugby, and World Rugby Chief Executive Alan Gilpin. New to the job, and he's absolutely thrilled with what he's seen here. The team's come out. IOC, I beg your pardon, not World Rugby, Robin Mitchell. It has been from this team, Argentina, against some incredible odds. So the players looking resplendent in their tracksuits come to the dais. And the medals will be presented at the end of one of the best rugby sevens tournaments there's ever been.
Dr. Robin E. Mitchell, membre de la commission exécutive du Comité international olympique, Fiji.
Executive board member of the International Olympic Committee, Fiji.
IOC, Fiji. Fiji.
Accompagné de.
Accompanied by.
Suzuki Mashite.
Monsieur Alan Gilpin, secrétaire général de World Rugby, Grande-Bretagne.
World Rugby Secretary General, Great Britain.
World Rugby 専務理事, 英国.
Médaille de bronze, Argentine.
bronze medalists, Argentina.
銅メダリスト、アルゼンチン。
Rodrigo Isgro, Lucio Cinti, German Schultz, Ignacio Mendy, Rodrigo Echart, Santiago Alvarez.
Nice moment there for Gaston Revol, who was sent off and suspended and left the field a distraught figure, but now he's got a smile on his face. This is a great effort from this team. All sorts of problems along the way, but they come up with a bronze medal at the end of it. So New Zealand step up, a silver medal for these players. They came here determined to do better than the team had done in Rio, and they've achieved that.
Tim Mickelson, Tony Inshu, Atini Naisuturo, Dylan Collier, Hiroshi Magami Black.
Flowers for the New Zealand team, getting those through New Zealand agricultural procedures when they get back to New Zealand. That'll be about as easy as finding their way through the Fijian defence, but enjoy them while they can, and the silver medal around their neck. Played their part in a wonderful tournament. They really did play some outstanding rugby along the way.
Médaille d'or et champion olympique, Fiji!
Gold medalists and Olympic champions, Fiji!
Team medalist, Olympic champion, Fiji!
Joshua Vakunabili, Nosifor Masi Balawariki, Kalioni Nasoko, Juta Wainangolo, Asele Tuavaka, Mele Derenalagi. Philemoni Botitu, Wasia Nathungu, Jerry Tuai, Aminiasi Tuimaba, Napoleoni Olata, Cirilli Mangala.
Well, a moment to treasure for these wonderful players, and especially for their captain, Jerry Tuai, who becomes the first Fijian to win two gold medals at the Olympic Games. What a proud moment for them, for their families, for their country. They really are the kings of the Sevens game, crowned again here in Tokyo.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne des Fiji.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Fiji.
皆様、フィジー国歌の演奏です。
Mesdames et messieurs,
what a great moment. in the lives of these young men. The Fiji flag proudly flying, the gold medals around the necks of the Fiji players, silver for New Zealand, bronze for Argentina. It has been a marvellous 3 days of Sevens rugby, as good a Sevens tournament as you have ever been able to witness. And at the end of it, the smiles tell it all. And now the celebrations start to break out. What joy this team brings to their nation, or to everyone who ever sees them, really. It's just the second time Fiji has won an Olympic medal, both of them gold, both of them won by their Sevens rugby team. The gold medal to Fiji, silver New Zealand, bronze Argentina, and that brings us to the end of a memorable men's sevens program here at Tokyo 2020, but there's so much still to look forward to. The women still to come, and that promises to be a great tournament as well. A few hours away from starting here in Tokyo on this very same stadium that's been lit up by these players. It's been a joy to behold. And now the joy, all with the Fiji players, their coach Gareth Baber held aloft. What a job he's done, emulating the feat of Ben Ryan before him. And that man there, number one, oh yes.